I'm a little late getting started today. We did a bit of community service. Coutts is a very old and almost forgotten town. And as you drive in from the north, you see these two old planters. They've been there for years. They've been filled full of garbage and weeds and junk. They look like heck. So we got the town to put some dirt in them. And this morning, Jim and I put some lilac roots in there. So in the next few weeks, hopefully, or the next time you drive through Coutts, just take a minute and look by the bar. You'll see these big planters full of lilacs, and you can say thank you to us. Anyway, the lilacs are planted, and I'm back at work. The last video I talked about, where does art come from? And that was kind of an interesting thing, as I said art comes from play. But also art comes from time and allowed to play as well. When I first started working on this pot, I said, I'll give it an hour. Its life was in the balance. And okay, I had to turn the whatever the creativity on at noon. I could go through my creativity until one, and then I'd go back to work, because I have to get this stuff out. So I sat down to do my creative bit and put the bottom on, but the bottom was too soft and I couldn't do anything with it. And I thought, well, that wrecks my whole time schedule. You can't do like mugs when it's creative time. Anyway, so I did, and I came back yesterday. And last week we had to get all this assigned and loaded and ready to go. And I came back yesterday and unloaded the kiln. And I was going to start washing and waxing and getting this ready to go. And the little teapot was sitting under the plastic going, play with me, play with me. So I thought, yeah, so I thought, well, why not? I mean, these, if they're another day or two before they get into the kiln, it'll be okay. So I thought, well, I'm going to put it on. The bottom was firm enough I could work with the teapot. I put on the three legs, like I said I was going to do, and the spout, and the handle for the third, the two and the one. And it didn't do anything for me. It just stood there like a funny teapot. So I ripped the legs off, and then I put on four legs, and it looked rather animal-like. I thought, well, it has a big nose. Let's give it little cloven hooves, and it'll be a pig. But pigs don't have long, skinny noses, and I didn't like the pig. So I ripped his little cloven hooves off, and then I put feet on. I thought, well, if I have front legs on the teapot, this is no longer a nose. I didn't want to do that either. So I put hands on the teapot, and I quite liked her. I gave her some like little funny bent legs and eyebrows, and it was fun. It was really fun. So I guess in this long process, art comes from play, time, and to give yourself the permission to play. Now, I don't often do that. I always seem to have lots to do, but it felt really nice to play. And so the next question is, what is it worth? So it took me, I could have probably made six teapots in the time it took me to play with this. So it does have a value of six teapots. I think what art is worth is the afternoon to go play in the studio. It has the same value as the afternoon to read a book or garden. It just feels really cool to do it. So what is art? It makes me happy. And if I like it, it's art. Anyway, I'm not sure if that makes any sense, but it didn't make any sense when I said it, so I had fun making it and it made me feel good, and now I have to get back to work. But before I get back to work, I'm going to show you a quick little trick on how to make the hands. They are fairly straightforward and easy to make once you know how. To make a hand, I'm just going to get a little piece of clay, well, depending on how big you want it. Now, this isn't the Leonardo da Vinci hand. This is a Cindy hand, and it's just a fun little sculpting hand. Get a little ball of clay and tap it out, and if you watch the clay teachers, it's as thick as a finger. And if you look at your hand has an angle here and then an angle there with a short thumb and your middle finger's the longest. So I'm just going to, with my little stick here, make the little hand shape. I'm going to make this is my shape there. And then with your needle, this is really cool. Here's my thumb. This is a left hand. So my thumb is there. To make it short. My index finger, middle finger, fourth finger, and little finger. My little finger is always short. Index finger is shorter than the middle finger, and your fourth finger is about the same size as your index finger. And look at that, I already have a little hand. Now this guy, you could put a little wrist on him, like I've done with her. I obviously gave that more time. You blend a little wrist on there, and if you take a little coil of clay, I didn't wet and wiggle, I'm not going to keep this, and you put a little coil of clay across there, you can blend it in, and see, very quickly you've got knuckles, and take the back of your stick, and you've got fingernails. So in about 2 seconds, you've got this cute little hand. You can even give them claws. I'm deciding if I want to give her claws or not. And claws, you get a little piece of clay, roll out a little tiny cone, and glue it on there, and then you've got long fingernails or claw-like things. Anyway, that's fun. For me, that's a lot more fun than washing and waxing mugs, but even if it is a lot more fun than washing and waxing mugs, I've got to get this on. These are student stuff that has to be done. Friday is our last day of students' classes as pickup. I got to get the student stuff done. I got to get these pots out, and I got to get to work. Anyway, when that's all done, I'm going to go dig out some more lilac roots for the town's planters, and then it'll be a day.